In this illustration, we'll study about heat exchange between two gases. Here we are given that a cylindrical container of volume V is divided in two equal parts by a fixed diathermic piston. And we are given that an ideal monoatomic gas is filled in the two parts at initial pressure and temperature P1 T1 and P2 T2. And after a long time when two gases are in thermal equilibrium, we are required to find the amount of heat supplied by gas in one part to the other part. Now, in this situation, we can consider as the gases are filled in two parts and they are connected by a diathermic partition, heat will be exchanged between the two, but total energy of gas remain constant. So, here we can write by conservation of energy, here we can write U1 plus U2 is equals to U final, where U1 and U2 are the internal energies of the two gases initially and U final is the final internal energy. So, here we can write as monoatomic gas we are using, internal energy of first gas we can write as N1 CV T1 plus internal energy of second gas is N2 CV T2. Where N1 and N2 are the number of moles of the two gases used and T1, T2 are initial temperatures. And if final temperature of the mixture of gases, or you can say the two gases when the heat is mixed between the two due to diathermic partition becomes TF, then the final internal energy can be written as N1 plus N2 CV TF. Here we are assuming TF is the final temperature of both the gases. Now, in this situation here, CV gets cancelled out as both are monoatomic gases. On simplifying, we'll get the final temperature of the gases, which is N1 T1 plus N2 T2 upon N1 plus N2. And here for number of moles we can use as N1 is equals to, by gas law, we can write down P1 V upon 2 RT1. A volume we are taking as V by 2. As total volume of container is V, which is divided in two equal parts. So here N2 is equals to P2 V by 2 RT2. So, if we use these values of N1 and N2 and substitute here, simplifying this gives us P1 plus P2 multiplied by T1 T2 divided by P1 T2 plus P2 T1. So, if this is the final temperature of the two gases, we can calculate directly the heat supplied by one gas to another is, here we can consider T1 as greater than T2, then we can write this heat supply delta Q as N1 CV T1 minus TF. Here we can write, assuming T1 is greater than T2, so heat will flow from first gas to the second one. On substituting the values, this gives delta Q is number of moles of first gas are P1 V upon 2 RT1 multiplied by CV for monoatomic gas, we can write 3 by 2 R multiplied by T1 minus TF, we are having P1 plus P2 multiplied by T1 T2 upon P1 T2 plus P2 T1. Now, here this R gets cancelled out, and when you simplify this relation, I just leave it as an exercise for you to simplify this expression and get the final result, which is 3 by 4 P1 P2 V multiplied by T1 minus T2 divided by P1 T2 plus P2 T1. This is the result of this problem.